What exactly is this Zika virus, and why are we particularly concerned about pregnant women?
Well, Zika is a virus that's transmitted by mosquitoes. The Zika virus was discovered many years ago in 1947 and has been around Southeast Asia, Africa, and some of the Pacific Islands. It generally was thought of, and is still for people who are not pregnant, an inconsequential virus. It gives symptoms of arthralgias, rash, fever, conjunctivitis, or redding in eyes, and then it goes away as a relatively mild illness. The problem that we're dealing with right now is that in Brazil and in other countries in South America and the Caribbean, it's clear that there is now an association in pregnant women who get infected during the pregnancy, namely who get bitten by a mosquito who transmits the Zika virus, that there is an alarming incidence of what we call microcephaly in the fetus or the baby. And that is a developmental abnormality of mm-hmm. small brain, and many of these children die. If they're born, they have a real difficult time following birth with a lot of impairments. So that's the thing that's causing the alarm. There will be cases reported in the United States, and there already have been.
In Hawaii, we know, yeah.
Yes, in Hawaii and in certain states, of people returning mm-hmm. who have been bitten and who have symptoms and are infected. So you shouldn't confuse that
right.
with it being spread within the United States.
Okay.
So you'll ask the possibility, can it ultimately, if someone comes back, start to have what we call primary spread within the United States? That's possible. We've seen that with dengue. Dengue
right.
is a similar type of a virus that is in South America and the Caribbean. And we've had over the years many little transmissions within the United States, in Florida, in the Florida Keys, and in Dade County, and in Texas. But that has been something that has been very well controlled. The idea of our having a major outbreak of Zika the way they're having in Brazil is extraordinarily unlikely. But we shouldn't be surprised if we continue to hear reports
okay.
of people who are coming back from that area and coming to the United States. And you should not confuse that with an outbreak
within
the United States.